we get to our last guest, we've got to bring in his biggest fan. You've probably noticed that Lisa is not at the desk tonight, but she is zooming us in from ISO, so far up the internet. Lisa, tell us where you are. How are you doing?
I can. Do you like my brand new accessory?
We love the headgear.
Lisa, you know that's not how you wear it, right?
Everyone's wearing these days. It's the accessory of the season. I'm actually 5 days into isolation. I got a little bit caught between New South Wales and Victoria. So I'm doing it from my bedroom tonight. But when I found out that Daryl was going to be on the show tonight, I insisted in being involved. And peeps at home, if you're ready, it's time for a sing-along.
How's That was the chart-topping hit from Sherbet, the Aussie rockers fronted by teen dream Daryl Braithwaite. His solo success includes a hit that still gets people flying to the dance floor in time for the chorus. That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. We'll be riding on the horses, yeah, yeah. Which turns out is a cover. In 2017, his mate Jimmy Barnes helped induct him to the ARIA Hall of Fame. And now, at 71 years young, he's got a brand new love song for us.
Daryl, it is so lovely to see you again.
Lisa, likewise.
I'm in my bedroom.
Yes, continue.
You're too shy to answer.
I think you just made Daryl Braithwaite blush.
Okay, I'll be a professional journalist now, Daryl. As you know, I've always considered the horses as basically Australia's unofficial anthem. And this new song, Love Songs, is right up there. Was it difficult finding a tune for you?
It was really luck. It came to me from a friend of mine, Peter, who actually asked if I could send it on to Roger Davies, who used to manage Sherbet, now manages Pink and a lot of other people. And I'm not really good with, the phone and stuff and attachments. So he never really got it. And 3 months later, I was sitting having lunch with him. And I said, did you like that song, that I sent to you? And he said, what song? And I sort of freaked out. I thought, oh, my God. And meanwhile, we've been playing it for 2 months and I had recording plans for it. And I sent it to him. He came back about an hour later and he kindly said, no, look, it's really, really good, but I think it suits you more than Alicia.
Daryl, can I just confirm something? Lisa just said it before and we heard it earlier. Your song is called The Horses.
Oh, yeah, The Horses.
I have
not horses.
I've seen you perform when I've been drunk so many times and I've heard people yelling out, right. Horses, play horses. No one has yelled out once, play The Horses.
No, illiterate. Victorians are very good. They yell out The Horses, but New South Wales people, not sure,
Daryl, your career record is phenomenal. You've been inducted into the ARIA Hall of Fame. You've sold out tours right around this country. You've had multi-platinum albums. And I'm just wondering, though, of all of those things, whether this is actually your career highlight. I would like to know, is seeing a duet with Lisa Wilkinson on breakfast television really sort of right up the top?
I have to add that I saw that I think that the channel that you were with went to a great deal of trouble, Lisa, and didn't they make a film clip with you on the beach and sort of you were playing Margaret Ehrlich's part and jumping and singing and all that stuff, which that was really good too.
That was really cool. In fact, shortly after I on breakfast TV with you, I left there. So don't ever think...
So the kiss of death. Okay. Well, this could be the end of you on the project as well.
Listen, Daryl Braithwaite's new single, Love Songs, is available to stream right now. I think probably at this point we're going to just dip out of this Zoom call.
Please.
Daryl, Lisa, we'll leave you to it. See you, Daryl.
Do you say bye-bye? Thank you.
Hey, guys. That was really fun.
It's a very weird time to say hello.
Let's do it all again. That's all we have time for tonight. MasterChef is up next. Stay away. Stay safe. Have a good night.
Bye.
Previously on MasterChef Australia.
Today, there are no rules.
It was no holds barred for Callum, Laura and Reynolds.
It's not just any dessert, this is the big gun that I'm pulling out.
As they let their imagination soar to showcase their very best creations.
I want to do a little Harry Potter-inspired dessert.
Yeah.
They wowed the judges with unbelievable dishes.
Flavour-wise, it was perfect.
But it was Reynolds' golden snitch that brought the magic.
Wow, wow, wow.
This dish is a game changer.
Earning him immunity and a fast track to finals week.
Well done.